Veo pasar.
Morning, Learn for Life students, families, teachers, and faculty. We are so glad to have you here. I was caught off a little off guard. I was enjoying the music and dancing a little bit and looked up and we were live. So I'm glad that we are here with you today with the University of Colorado at Denver, and we're very happy to have them here. A brief overview of our College Access Program. The College Access Program is a lifelong learning initiative, lending a platform for the growing collaboration between Learn for Life schools and participating higher education institutions. We partner with institutions that offer outstanding support for Learn for Life students to fulfill their goals, such as historically Black colleges, Hispanic-serving institutions, and other organizations, colleges, and schools. Together, we seek to strengthen and promote three of our goals: college access, college readiness, and persistence to graduation for any student who is a Learn for Life student. So, with that, we are going to have a video brought to you from Michael Georges Jr. Michael is a rapper, musician, singer out of the Charlotte, North Carolina area, and he has a message for our Learn for Life students. Let's go with that.
Learn for Life students, what's good? My name is Michael Georges Jr., also known as the General or the Weird Genius, whatever you want to call me. Listen, I'm your
big brother, your uncle, your cousin, I'm something.
All in one. That's not important. Listen, I'm sitting here working, doing some music and things like that, and I just wanted to take a moment and just encourage you all, you know? There was a wise philosopher by the name of Frederick Douglass that wrote a quote that said, "Without struggle, there'd be no progress." That line, that statement held dear to me most of my life because of all the experiences that I've went through, from gang life, from street life, you know, drugs, violence, all those different things, and the list goes on. But throughout all of my struggles, I learned from those things. I grew from them. I became better. So I'm a product of the struggle and the progress. So I wanted to encourage you all and tell you all, it doesn't matter whatever it is that you've experienced before now, whatever you've endured or went through before now, you're at this point, which means you made progress. I, for one, am proud of you and thankful that you made it to this point. And it doesn't stop here, because you still got more progress to go. So even as you take these tours of these schools and experience things that are beyond your wildest dreams, I'm encouraging you to keep going through, keep pressing forward. You gotta just have faith, you gotta believe it. There's an old song that always told me,
as long as you keep your head to the sky,
you can be whatever it is you wanna be, all right? So from me to you, I just wanna wish you all a salute, love, peace, and blessings. Don't be good, be great, you heard? All right, let me get back to work, all right. Holla.
We'd like to thank the general for doing this work for us. It is important that you know that you have supporters all over the United States Learn for Life students who want to see you do well, who are invested in your outcomes. And with that said, I would like to introduce to you our Contractual College Access Program Manager, the hostess with the mostess, Ms. Cheryl Moore. Cheryl, take us away.
Thanks so much, Michelle. Thanks so much. Listen, this is bittersweet because this is our last day and our final presentation, but I'm so excited. We have had an absolute blast hanging out with all of you this week, and we want to thank you for sticking it out with us. Thank you so very much. We've had a week filled with inspiration and with information, and we pray that you have downloaded all that you've heard into your minds, and then we're going to help you process that into actuality, because we want to see you be successful, and we're going to walk with you through and to the next phases of your lives. Listen, we are excited today to have with us, all the way from the University of Colorado Denver, home of the Lynx and a Hispanic serving institution, the incomparable Miss Alexandra Slaughter. Hi, Alex.
Hi, Cheryl and Michelle. Thank you again so much for having me today.
Thank you for being here. We're so excited. Listen, you are pulling up the rear and you are taking us out of here with the final presentation. So we can't wait to hear what you have to share.
Perfect. Awesome. Well, I will go ahead and get started. And again, thank you so much and welcome to all of you tuning in. Hopefully this, you know, will be able to be the best and final presentation for you. And kind of like echoing what Cheryl said, definitely know that I'm also here to help you out as you're kind of going through this process. So just know I'm the admission counselor here at CU Denver who works with all of our out-of-state students. So anytime you have questions at the end, my contact information will pop up at the end of this presentation. So just know you're more than welcome to reach out to me anytime as you're going through this college search. So just know, you know, I'm here to help out. But yeah, so I will go ahead and kind of jump into this, give you guys a little overview of CU Denver and let you, you know, learn a little bit more about our campus. So a little bit about kind of our location. So we are located right in the heart of downtown Denver. A lot of students, this is kind of the number one reason why they pick CU Denver, because we're located right in downtown Denver. You're walking distance to so many awesome things. So you're walking distance to, you know, the Denver Performing Arts Center, to a lot of different sporting events. There's a lot of fun things to do on the weekend, which I'll talk about a little bit later. But kind of with the campus, we have our Tivoli Student Union, which houses, you know, tons of food options. All of our clubs and organizations are housed in the Tivoli. We also have the 16th Street Mall. So this is only two blocks from campus. This has tons of restaurants, shops, the works. This is, you know, your go-to place if you want to go to a coffee shop, if you want to go get a burger, if you want to go get a vegan, you know, any kind of food. It's off of 16th Street Mall. Also with Union Station. So Denver is a great city, especially even if you don't have a car. So if you're wanting to kind of stay in the city, definitely know Union Station's easy to get around. So as a student, you actually get an RTD pass. So with the RTD pass, this is where you're able to ride the light rail, you're able to ride the bus, and it goes all over the Denver metro area. We have 2 light rail stops on campus, so it's really easy to get around. And it does go to and from the airport. So that means you can ride it all the way to the airport if you're going home for Christmas, if you're going on a fun spring break trip with friends. You can ride it for free. Like I said, you get that RTD pass. You can ride it for free out to the airport. And then also too, you know, we're in Colorado. The Rocky Mountains are, you know, in our backyard. It's about a 15-minute drive to the foothills, which is like Golden and Evergreen. Personally, myself, I love hiking. I love being outdoors. So it's great being so close to so many different hiking trails. We're also super close to all of the ski resorts. So a little bit of kind of what you can do on the weekend. The options are endless. So if you're wanting to stay in the city, you can go to music festivals. You can go to the museum, to the Denver Zoo. If you're a sports fan, we have all 8 major sports teams. And as a student, you get discounted tickets. So you can go see the Nuggets, the Avalanche, the Rockies. You can get discounted tickets as a student to all of these. Ball Arena, which is where the Nuggets, the Avalanche, and the Mammoth play, which is basketball, hockey, and indoor lacrosse. They're literally a block across the street. So it's super close, easy to go. The Rockies with baseball is about a 10-minute walk north. And then also, too, with all the ski resorts. So Colorado has some of the best ski resorts in the entire nation. So you're not going to be lacking on fun things to do on your weekend. There's a lot of fun things. As part of our wellness center, we actually have the Adventure Desk, which I'll talk a little bit about later, but they do ski trips as well through the university. Then kind of shifting gears a little bit to our academics, because, you know, this is college. I mean, you want to have fun on the weekends too, but you also, you know, are looking for academics and finding that right program for you as well. So we have tons of different degree programs. So we have about 140 different degree programs, and they do range. So kind of quickly going through our schools and colleges, if you're not quite aware, a lot of universities kind of break out all of their majors into schools and colleges. And so kind of our 140 different degree programs are kind of broken out into these different schools and colleges. With our College of Architecture and Planning, we are the only undergraduate architecture program in the entire state of Colorado. And so if you're interested in architecture, we are a great place to come. With our College of Arts and Media, we are actually the first of its kind in Colorado, and we have a lot of students who will go work for Disney Pixar as part of our animation program. Actually, one of our graduates won an Oscar for his work on Frozen. With our film program, a lot of students will go work for Netflix. The lead sound engineer from Game of Thrones is a CU Denver grad from our film school. And we also have our music program. So with music, we have singer-songwriter. We also have music business. We have recording arts. And so there's a lot of different options there. A lot of students will go work for a lot of students will move to LA or Nashville or New York after graduating. I know one of our student ambassadors here in the Office of Admissions has actually got an internship at Spotify. So there's a lot of options there. A lot of your professors are Grammy award-winning writers and songwriters, and so a lot of cool things out of that program. We also have a great graphic design program. Like I mentioned, our animation program is awesome. It's actually in the top 25 in the entire nation. And so definitely with the College of Arts and Media, there's a lot of options there. As a first-year student, we actually have an entire floor in our residential hall dedicated to College of Arts and Media students. They have recording spaces and all that, and they have classes that are set aside specifically for College of Arts and Media. So if you're kind of wanting that that environment and kind of having that close-knit community, definitely that's, you know, a great program to pick there. With our business school, it's kind of your typical business school. We are in the top 5% for business schools in the entire nation, though. We do have a partnership with Jake Japs, who is the CEO and founder of American Furniture Warehouse, which is this huge furniture company out here in the Rocky Mountains. And he actually does a program called The Climb, which is kind of like Shark Tank if you've ever seen the TV show. And so every year, every student who's enrolled in an entrepreneurship class can actually present their ideas to him. So they can present to him, say, this is what I'm looking for. And every semester, he'll pick his favorite and give that student $10,000 startup money, which is not too shabby. With our School of Education and Human Development, that is our teacher certification program. It is everything from early childhood, pre-K, all the way up through 12th grade and special education. So if you're looking to become a teacher, it's a great program for you, or even go into social work or anything like that. With our College of Engineering, Design, and Computing, we have a lot of different options for you. You know, there's mechanical, civil, electrical. We also have bioengineering, which is one of the first of its kind as well, where it actually mixes kind of more of the medical side. And then We also have with our mechanical engineering program, they actually have a partnership with the NFL where they're helping to design helmets to protect against concussions, which is really cool. It's a $500 million grant that we've been given. So that's a pretty cool program there as well. With our School of Public Affairs, that's our criminal justice and kind of all of our public service majors. So if you're wanting to go into local, state, federal government, if you're wanting to go into, to the FBI, CIA, law enforcement, that is kind of the school for you. And then last but not least is our College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. This is our largest college. It kind of encompasses all the rest of our majors. So everything from political science to psychology, English, history, and then all of our sciences, chemistry, physics, biology. Biology is our number one major because we do have a partnership with the Anschutz Medical Campus. So if you are interested in going to nursing school, PT school, physician's assistant, dentistry, medical school, any of those, we do have a partnership with the Anschutz Medical Campus. And so you do get a pre-health advisor. Her name's Tricia. She is awesome. So she'll help you make sure you're doing all the right steps to get into nursing or medical school. After you're done at CU Denver, we have a shuttle that goes back and forth between our campus and the Anschutz campus. So a lot of students will do research. They'll do internships. They'll shadow over at Anschutz. And so we do have a 97% placement rate into medical school. So if you're interested in going to medical school, we are also an awesome choice for you as well. Kind of speaking of research there, we are the only urban public institute in the state of Colorado that has undergraduate research. So a lot of people, when they think of research, they think, and obviously the picture is of lab coats, but it's a lot more than that. So students at CU Denver can really dive into any topic that interests them. So if you're a business student, one of our business students looked into how film festivals impact local economies. Another student was writing a children's book and partnered with the Denver Zoo. And so research can really be about anything that interests you. And so just know that here at CU Denver, we're really going to give you those tools to really dive into things that interest you. And then other tools that are available to you. So not only, can you do research, but we also have a few other things that are available to every single student free of charge. So this is, available to you as a student. So we have our career services and experiential learning. So they do everything from resume workshops, mock interviews. They do career fairs. With experiential learning, they help with internships. Every year, about 1,000 students get placed at different internships throughout Denver. With our global education, this is our study abroad office. And so a lot of our study abroad opportunities, they span the globe. So you can go anywhere. We have faculty-led programs. We have semester-long programs. You can go for a week at spring break. I would highly, 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 highly encourage you to study abroad. No matter what school you pick, no matter what college you choose, definitely study abroad because it is an amazing opportunity. I personally studied abroad. I went to Germany when I was in college and I loved it. It gave me a lot of independence. It just taught me a lot about myself. And I really, truly feel that I'm originally from Texas, and I don't think I would have moved up to Denver by myself after graduating if I hadn't studied abroad, because it really did kind of teach me like that I can make it out there. We also have our Learning Resource Center. So we do offer free tutoring. We have a writing center. We have a math lab. All this is available. It's actually right next door to our residential hall, so it's super easy access. You could walk to the tutoring center within 2 minutes, of your residential hall, of your room. And then also too, kind of like they mentioned, we are, a Hispanic serving institute. So we do have a very diverse student body. And kind of with that, we also have a lot of resources available for our diverse students. So we have our Center for Identity and Inclusion. So this is to support any underrepresented minority student. We have counselors available for every single race and ethnicity. There's also a women and gender counselor. We have tons of LGBT QIA resources. I mean, there's tons that are available for students no matter what you're struggling with, what you're dealing with. We also have the Phoenix Center, which is there to help out with free counseling as well. So there's tons and tons of options. I think the key with CU Denver is just make sure, just be vocal that there's tons of resources to help you out. And the key is just to kind of, let people know that you need help. And there's, tons of options available. And then switching gears a little bit with our student life, I guess not really switching gears, but kind of speaking a little more kind of on to the diversity aspect. So like I said, we're a very diverse school. So about 42% of our students are students of color. 49% of our students are first generation students. So those are the first, in their family to go to school. We have 48 different states represented, 64 different countries. And so really though, at CU Denver, there's tons of options, and you're definitely, not going to be alone. There's going to be students from all walks of life that you're going to get to meet. And then a little bit about student life, the fun things to do. This is college. Like I said, you're going to want to be having fun on the weekends. We have about 120 different clubs and organizations. We have about 15 club sports. And so definitely join a club. my two big pieces of advice for you, you know, join a club and study abroad. Those are kind of the big two that you should definitely, you know, make sure you do in college. Also with our student government, they are actually paid positions. So if you run for student government, you do get paid for this. And they make a lot of the change happen at CU Denver. One of the unique things about our university is we are a younger university and there's still a lot of change happening. So there's still a lot of things that are kind of being molded and students are really able to be vocal and letting their voices be heard. So our Lynx, our mascot, was actually a student idea. So about 8 years ago, we did not have a mascot. And so students were like, hey, we want a mascot. And so they voted on the Lynx, they voted on his name, Milo. All of that was student run. Also with the Wellness Center, that was actually a student idea as well. So with the Wellness Center, students wanted a place to hang out in between classes. They wanted, you know, a rec center. So they petitioned the Board of Regents and our students were able to get it built about 3 years ago. So again, we really listen to our students and you can really make a difference. A lot of our students are very into social activism. A lot of the, you know, hot button issues in our country right now, students are being at the forefront. A lot of our students actually are, you know, are petitioning at the Capitol for different policy changes. So it's really cool to be a part of an environment where students are really actively seeking change, you know, and trying to make a difference. So kind of speaking of the Wellness Center, though, this is, you know, free for you as well. It's included in your tuition. So there's two floors of gym equipment. There's a rock climbing wall. There's a lap pool. There's an 18-person hot tub. There's a nap room. There's tons of fun things, like tons of study spaces, beanbag chairs, foosball. This is the place you're going to go to hang out with your friends. And then, like I mentioned earlier, with the Adventure Desk, they do ski trips, hiking trips. They also rent out equipment. So if you wanted to rent out camping equipment, stand-up paddle boards, anything like that, go to the Adventure Desk so they can hook you up. And then a little bit of kind of our application process. So we are a pretty straightforward, easy application process compared to a lot of other schools. So you can either apply through our website or through the Common App. For our juniors on this, it does open on August 1st. So August 1st is when the application for fall of 2022 is going to open. Mark your calendars, get excited. So you just go to the application, fill it out. We do have a $50 application fee, but we can waive this. So there are fee waiver codes, you know, if you're on free and reduced lunch, if your family is experiencing economic hardships, we are more than welcome to waive this fee because we would hate for it to be a hindrance for you applying to school. So just know that is an option to be waived. And then all we need are your high school transcripts. That's it. We don't need letters of recommendation. We don't need a resume, no test scores, none of that. We just need the application, your high school transcripts. You are good to go. I will say our average GPA is about a 3.2. I would say shoot for above a 3.0. We do offer merit scholarships. Our merit scholarships are based off of your high school GPA. So obviously the higher your high school GPA, the higher the merit scholarship that you can receive. And a little bit too, if you do fall below a 3.0, I would say don't lose hope. We do review every single student. We are a smaller school. We have about 11,000 students. So we're a pretty medium-sized school, but as far as the application process goes, we are able to review every single student who applies. So if you are falling below a 3.0, just know you can send in letters of recommendation. You can send in a personal statement and really kind of make your application stand out a little bit more. And then breaking down the cost a little bit. So we do have different tiers depending on where you live. And so for the WUE, which is the Western Undergraduate Exchange Rate, this is for all of the states west of Colorado and kind of including the Dakotas. And so this gives you a discounted rate. There is nothing extra that you have to do to be a part of WUE. It is automatically included just based off of your home address. So as long as your home address is in one of those states, you automatically qualify for WUE. Which it's a great program. So it does save you about $12,000 on out-of-state tuition, which is awesome. And then these numbers are before those merit scholarships, before financial aid, and before any other scholarships that you could apply for. So definitely know that these are kind of the sticker price, and then they're going to go down from there. And then with out-of-state, it's about $30,000. But again, before financial aid and before scholarships. A few quick tips for you as you're looking through colleges during your senior year of high school, apply for as many outside scholarships as you can. There are tons of databases out there. There are scholarships.com, iGrad.com, fastweb.com. There's a lot out there, scholarshipmonkey.com. Start going to some of these databases during that senior year and apply. Apply for as many as you can, especially the ones with essays, because very few people apply for the ones with essays. So go through, apply for all of those. They definitely help out. Even if it's $500, $500 makes a huge difference. And then a little bit about living on campus. So at CU Denver, we actually do not require students to live on campus. So it is up to you if you live on campus or off. I would highly encourage you though to live on campus your first year just because it's an amazing experience. You get to meet so many more people. It's such an easier way to kind of get immersed in the campus community and really feel included and involved. We do have a brand new residential hall, so it is actually being completed as we speak. It's going to be set to be complete in the next month or so, and it will be open for this first fall. So you will be like the second or third people ever to live in this room. It's still going to be basically pretty new by the time you guys get here. And so we're really excited about that, though. We do offer, you know, different floor plans. There's going to be a dining hall. There's going to be an Einstein Bagels. There's tons of study spaces, TVs, homework, you know, study rooms, and all of that. And then we also have first year experiences. So first year experiences are going to be there to kind of help you through, you know, that transition of going from high school to college. So first year experiences, not only are they going to do tons of events in the residential hall, housing is going to do tons of events in the residential hall, and then also, you know, joining your clubs and organizations. So definitely live on campus your first year, because it really will kind of make that transition so much easier, you know, and so much more smoothly, and just meeting people. It really gives you, you know, the opportunity. They do tons of movie nights. They've done luau's. They did succulent plant parties. So they definitely offer a lot of opportunities there. So with City Heights, I mean, I would suggest you live on campus your first year, especially because it's going to be brand new. And you probably won't be able to find anything nicer in Denver. But yeah, so that is kind of CU Denver in a nutshell. A little bit about me. You know, like I said, I'm from Texas, so I know what it's like to move from Denver from out of state. I do work with all of our students from across the US, so any other state other than Colorado, that is me. And so definitely just know to feel free to reach out to me if you have questions. Like I said, my contact information would be up at the end. So here it is. You know, call me, beat me, shoot me an email anytime you have questions. That is what I'm here for. I'm here to help you through the application process. And even as, you know, next year's coming around and you're deciding on colleges, even if you don't pick CU Denver, just know I am a resource for you. I know sometimes college, you know, it can be stressful. It can be a little daunting. So just know you have a friendly face on the other side who can really kind of help you out and figure out just kind of, you know, ways to, you know, walk you through it. And so that is kind of my spiel on CU Denver. And so I think we are opening it up to questions, if I remember correctly.
Yes, we are, Alex. Thank you so very much for all of that information. Listen, one of our consultants, Peter Groff, is from Denver, so I know he is uber excited to have you sharing with us today. I think he even may be watching. So shout out to Peter from the CAP team. Are there any questions or comments, Michelle, that you may have right now for Alex?
Well, first of all, I would just like to thank you, Alex, for that beautiful presentation. I was sold on your university on the first, I think it was the second slide with the slopes with the Rockies in the background. I was like, okay, I want to come. So it is a beautiful university. Also, I just want to point out to our students, the limited amount of things you need to do to apply. I see, Alex, that you have cut out a lot of those steps for students just to make it easier to apply to your university. So I just wanted to thank you for that. Do we have questions in the queue?
Yes, ma'am. Let's start with, what do I do next if my GPA isn't where it should be when I graduate but want to still apply?
Awesome. Yeah. So, I mean, there's definitely a lot of steps that, you know, the student can take to really kind of help out. So, depending if they're coming up on their senior year, they could always wait until their first semester after senior year. So start applying around December, kind of wait and for that first few months to get that first semester in, and maybe that might help raise a GPA. If you're, you know, already a senior, already graduated from high school and kind of figuring out next steps, I would suggest if you're, you know, if your GPA is on the lower end, go to a community college, you know, go, you know, get some of those core classes, really kind of get a GPA up. So for us, if you have 24 credits, which is about two semesters worth from a community college, we don't look at your high school. So all you would need is just that community college. And so go to community college, even for just a semester or for a whole year, and that could definitely help you out and then kind of set you up for success and applying for universities kind of after that if you've already graduated. But if you haven't graduated, maybe wait until after senior, you know, that first semester of senior year, see if you can't get your GPA up, and then kind of go from there. But we're definitely willing to work with you. Definitely don't give up hope. College is definitely still an option. So just know that there's a lot of steps that can definitely be taken.
Great, thank you. And then I see, how long does the admissions process take once the application is submitted?
Yeah, so if you kind of apply between August to October, our first round of decisions are going to go out in mid-November. So that's going to be kind of the first big wave. After that, it's every 2 weeks. So if you apply, say, early December, it takes about 2 weeks for you to get a decision after that. And so it's a pretty fast turnaround. If you're applying in like September, October timeframe, just know your decision would go out around mid-November.
Okay, great. And the last two questions kind of go together. Is there a virtual option or a hybrid option? And what kind of online programs do you have?
Yeah, so there are kind of two different options. And so we do kind of with COVID, we are going to be fully back in person this fall, but there are some programs like business, criminal justice, you know, there are some programs that are still offering a lot of classes online just because it is easier accessible for a lot of students. We do have an atypical student body population kind of makeup. We do have a lot of students who are working full time, or, you know, they're parents, or, you know, they're coming from different walks of life. So there are a lot of online classes that are available as well. A lot of it does kind of depend on the major, because if you're doing a science or one of the film or architecture, a lot of those classes do have to be in person because of the labs, because of just the interactive, just the pieces. But we do have a pretty lengthy online program as well. You could actually do all 4 years fully online if you wanted to. For certain programs, I think there's about 15 that are offered fully online, which ranges from like psychology, a few of the education, like social work ones. So there's definitely some options, but it kind of depends on the major, because if you're wanting to get teacher certification, obviously you have to be in a classroom to get those hours in, so it's harder to do that online. But if you're wanting to just do psychology, you can do that online. So a lot of it just kind of depends on the major.
Cool. Thanks, Alex.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Alex. Listen, this is the last day, and this was the final presentation. And with that, I want to ask Michelle if she has any parting words for us before we close out.
Yes, thank you so much, Cheryl and Alex. Again, thank you for that wonderful presentation. We really appreciate it. Students, thank you, and your families, our counselors, teachers, faculty, and staff at Learn for Life Schools for hanging out with us this week, exposing your students to these opportunities. We definitely believe that access makes all the difference. And we want to make sure that you have access to a pathway that will garner you a post-secondary opportunity. We realize how competitive the world is, and we're not saying that all students, you know, must go to a university. We believe in different things like entrepreneurship, and we know that the next Bill Gates is out there, and we believe it may even be within our organization. So that's not what we're saying, but what we are saying is that if a post-secondary pathway is what you have always dreamed of, or maybe a week ago you didn't know it was a dream, and today you're like, wait a minute, maybe I can do this. What I want you to know is that there is a dedicated team of College Access Program staff who will help you get there. Not only that, once you are in college, we offer services like mental health check-ins, academic check-ins. We've devised a retention plan for you. We also have partnered with community members to make sure that if you need a haircut, if you need your nails done, maybe you're just sick of eating food in the cafeteria and you want to find someone who can, you know, make a great dish that you're familiar with, we want to make sure that you have those resources. So in closing, what I'd like to say is, you've heard from our national superintendent earlier in the week Dr. Caprice Young. You've heard from our Chief Academic Officer, Mr. Christopher Hodge. You've heard from our Regional Superintendent, Ms. Julie Parra. And today, you heard from our Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Pete Barasha. And one message that is clear within each of those messages to you is that we believe in you, we believe in your ability, and that we care about you beyond your youth. So with that, I will turn it back over to my partner in crime, the hostess with the mostest, Ms. Cheryl Moore, to close us out for this college week. And we will see you back here in September.
Yes, we will, Michelle. Yes, we will. This is bittersweet. We have to sign off and say goodbye to all of you. A couple of things we need to do, and that is a huge shout out to the CAP Dream Team. Thank you to our fearless leader, Michelle Harvey, Danielle, Lorena, Jasmine, the other Michelle, Michelle Van Kirk, Claudia, Heaven, Peter, Charles, Zach, and John, who are our tech gurus. Also, thank you so, so very much to our incredible CEO, Pete, the team, leadership, faculty, and staff over at Learn for Life. And finally, last but not least, to all of our incredible students. Listen, you may be wondering, okay, I've listened to all of this. What do I do next? What are the next steps? Well, just two quick things. Number one, make a decision. Decide that, yes, I am going to college. You don't have to know where you're going to go. Just decide that you're going to go. And we will help you figure out everything else along the way. So number one, make a decision. Number two, make a connection. Reach out to your counselor. Your counselor will reach out to us, and we will connect you to what we believe is your destiny. Make a decision and make a connection. You may be thinking, this is all overwhelming. I don't know. Sometimes I'm unsure about myself. Sometimes I've had other people say things to me that have made me unsure about myself. Well, in the words of the singer-songwriter, Ms. Selena Gomez, she said, who says you're not star potential? Who says you're not presidential? Who says you can't be in the movies? Listen to me. Listen to me. Who says you can't pass the test? Who says you can't be the best? Who says? Who says? Listen, forget about what they said. We say that you are worthy. We say that you are worth it. And we say that you are a winner. So guess what? We will see you in the winner's circle. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and we'll see you right back here in September. Take good care, everyone. Salute.